How's it going, guys? I'm your host Korriban Gaming. Welcome back to a very special Dragon Fable video. So as you guys can tell from the title, this video will serve as a farming guide for people who want to either grind for EXP or grind for gold inside of Dragon Fable. So Dragon Fable, this game has been well over 10 years old by now, and because of the whole lockdown situation, there are many new players discovering the game every day, and of course there is that one video of someone defeating Seppi on YouTube floating around, which is why Dragon Fable is getting quite a lot of attention nowadays. On top of that, there are many old returning players who want to revisit their childhood games, especially for 90s kids such as myself, who used to play AE games all the time when we were young. So everybody's stuck in lockdown, they are discovering their old games like Club Penguin, all that kind of stuff, you know. And then we also have Dragon Fable. So people may want to level up their character quickly now that the level cap has been increased by so much. I remember the very first time I played Dragon Fable, the level cap was like 40. Yeah, so it was a very, very long time ago, and now the new level cap is level 90. There's been lots of new stuff, lots of changes added into the game for sure. Okay, so let me give you guys some general tips first if you are looking to farm or to grind EXP or gold. So the very first tip I want to give you guys is take breaks. Okay, so you want to pace yourselves. I think every 2 hours taking a break is a pretty good idea, so you don't burn yourself out too quickly. You know, have a walk, go out, do something else, eat your lunch or something like that. I don't know, man. 2 hour break, every 2 hours take a short break and then come back and continue the grind. You know, this not only helps you to alleviate the boredom of grinding. I mean, grinding is a very long and very tedious process that you have to continuously do in order to get what you want. So taking breaks will definitely help you. It is also helpful to have something off to the side to do while you are actually farming or grinding. Okay, maybe you could listen to a podcast, listening to music, watch some long videos. That's what I like to do at the site. And for most people, this actually boosts their productivity and helps to alleviate the problem of boredom, which comes around quite frequently, especially if you're doing the same thing over and over again. All right. Now, the second tip that I want to give you guys is to turn your graphics down to low, and you can do that in cell options, not the book of law, sorry. Okay, so you want to turn your graphics down to low. This will make sure your game is running more smoothly and it's not as laggy, because it is not so graphics intensive. For myself, I can leave it at high because my PC is pretty decent. On top of that, I'm also making a video. I'm not really grinding for real now, so I'm going to leave it up at high. Weather effects, you want to turn it off. Okay, and seasonal borders, you want to turn it off as well. Why is that so? It's because these two, they add a lot of extra fluff to the game that you don't really need, and will most likely slow down the game. Even though the two places which I will be showing you, one for EXP grinding and one for gold grinding, do not have any weather effects, I think it's still better to turn it off just in case. You never know. I mean, it doesn't hurt to turn it off, right? So that's what you should be doing. Next tip for your game to run more smoothly: don't ever use this Dragon Scythe or Elementals, whether it's the Ultimate Scythe or the Doom Scythe, even the Ancient Scythe. The Ancient Scythe is not as laggy compared to the Doomed and the Ultimate version, but I would say don't use it. Try not to use it as far as possible. On top of that, this is also a item that is a paid item. It costs 500 DCs, even though you can get DCs for free in the game right now, but this thing only comes around once every year, and I will assume that not many people actually have it. So a good alternative for this will be the Soul Forge weapons. The Soul Forge weapons are free. They do take a little bit of time to get, but you know, it's still not too difficult, and it is absolutely one of the strongest weapons inside the game. So stick with the Soul Forge side. That is what I would recommend. Okay, for other gear, you want to find a class which is a class that deals a lot of very high damage. Ideally, you want to find a class that has an auto crit skill that can allow you to kill whatever enemies that you are going to grind against in one hit. That will be best because it will save you a lot of time in the long run, making you more efficient at farming. For this video, I've chosen to go with Chaos Weaver. I think it's a very good armor for both EXP grinding and gold grinding. Okay, for the back item, the best in slot offensive back item will be the Chaos Weaver's cloak. If you don't have the dragon coins to buy this item, you can get the Soul Mender's cloak instead. The stats are not as great as the Chaos Weaver's cloak, but it is a option for free to play players to consider. Soul Forge ring, you can buy this from the Ravenloss shop. Okay, Distorted Doom Visage, you can get this helm from one of the Caitiff storyline quests. Okay, Defender's Dragon Necklace. Now this is one thing that I would foresee many players actually do not have, because this one takes a huge and very long time to grind out the Defender's medals needed. Okay, so if you don't have this, then choose another necklace. Another necklace I recommend is the Unhaloed Death Knight Amulet. It's pretty good offensive necklace as well, so you guys can consider using that. For trinkets, I'll go with Yuenta's Blaster 4 charging. You can also use Vel's Eagle, it's pretty good too. For belts, I got the Major Challenger belt. You can get this belt from the Inn at the Age of Time, the Valyrus Gauntlet Challenge. And for artifacts, I will go with any of the Epoch artifacts, or if you are not a pay to win player, you can go for the Necro Paragon artifact as well. He has the exact same stats as the Epoch artifacts, but you have to do one of the Time Torn challenges in the Inn of the Age of Time in order to get those artifacts. Alright, and keep in mind, all of my gear that I've shown here is the best in slot offensive gear at max level, at end game level, the best gear that money can buy, the best gear that you can get from completing the toughest challenges inside the game. That being said, if you don't have this gear, what I recommend you to do is if you're using another gear and you're deciding which gear to use, I would prioritize these two stats. The first stat will be crit. Okay, you want to prioritize crit, and the second stat you want to prioritize is intelligence. So prioritize these two stats. You don't need to care about BPD, you don't need to care about MPM, you definitely don't need to care about resist as well, because you just want to kill the enemy as quickly as possible. You don't need to care about your defenses, and ideally you will be able to kill the enemy before they can kill you or even touch you at all for that matter. And that is how you can grind the most efficient manner possible. For character stats, now, you guys might be wondering, what in the world is going on? Why am I investing in charisma? Hear me out first, okay? So, you want to invest 200 points into charisma because after the stat changes, each additional guest that you bring along at 200 charisma, you get an extra 20% gold and EXP. So if I bring along two guesses, which is the maximum amount you can bring, you're getting an extra 40% EXP and gold boost if you train 200 charisma. So I'll definitely recommend training this, okay, if you're at endgame with the best gear. Now this is only helpful if you can one shot the monster. If you're taking more than one turn to kill the monster, you're better off investing the stat points into something like strength to up your base damage, or more luck to increase your critical strike rate. Okay, so if you can kill the enemy in one hit, then definitely go for charisma to get that little bit of gold and EXP boost right there. For the remaining 45 points, I just dump them into luck for a little bit of direct hit chance and a little bit more critical hit chance, but it shouldn't matter if you're using an auto crit skill anyway. Okay, for the two guests, it doesn't matter what you bring. I've chosen to go with Artix and Rolliff. Both have a pretty high bonus and both also deal quite a lot of damage, which is what I want if I really have no choice but to fall back on them. That being said, chances are you shouldn't even need to enter your guest's turn if you are farming in the most efficient manner possible. You also probably shouldn't need your baby dragon at all, but you know, just in case you want to bring along your baby dragon as well, for baby dragon, I would recommend you to put 200 points into magic, and that's really all you need. You don't need a 600 points fully fed dragon, you really just need 200 points into magic. And why this is so is because for magic, you get this very powerful supernova skill, which gives 200 crit and extra 200% damage for a grand total of 600% damage. On top of that, it has a very fast skill animation, and it also element 6. So you don't need to care about which element your dragon is actually aligned to if you have the Dragon Nova skill, right? And that is basically the setup that you want to go. Now for the very first spot I want to talk about, you want to go up to Ash Quest's challenge, and this is none other than the very infamous or famous Dr. Voltabot's challenge that has been here since the start of the game. Okay, so this is a fantastic place for farming EXP. In fact, it is the best possible place in the game if you want to farm EXP. If you want to farm gold as well, this is also a good place. It's not as good as the other place that I'm going to mention later on in the video, but it's still a very good place to farm gold, especially if you don't have the gear for the second place, alright? So if you want to farm EXP, this is the best place. For gold, it's not such a bad place either. Okay, from the quest, you'll get either scrap metals, which you can sell for 15 gold each, or if you're lucky, you can get a battle call, which you can sell for 500 gold. Even better, if you have a few pieces of scrap metal, you can combine with battle call to form a torque, and the torques will sell for 1000 gold each. Okay, for this quest, all you really need is a good energy weapon right here. And if you are a pay to win player and you have Sun God Scythe, then definitely have Sun God Scythe shown, because all of the monsters here are all elementals, and you'll gain a little bit of extra damage boost against elementals, which is really good. So the skill sequence will just be Gambit, Untangle, and that's it. The battle is done. 7208 EXP and 301 gold just from that alone. So very, very fast, and you can easily get over 50,000 EXP from this quest in under a minute. So this is by far, hands down, the best place that you want to farm EXP. Let's move on to the next area. Alright, the gold farming spot. So the gold farming spot, you want to go into Book 1, the Orb Saga, Wind Orb, Shadow of the Wind Village. You can access this place from your Book of Law as well, but I think it's faster, slightly faster if you go through... No, you can access this place from the travel map as well, but I think it's slightly faster if you go to it using the Book of Law like what I did. Okay, and for this quest, you will need Yuragiri. Okay, this is the highest possible... base damaging weapon inside of the game. You can get this from the Inn at the Age of Time. It's from one of the you can get this from the AARGH series of challenges, whereby you get to fight all of the different inn bosses at the same time. Okay, so it does take a little bit of grinding to get to, but if you have this weapon, it'll be perfect for this quest since it deals the highest amount of damage. For shown weapons, you want to show your Vow Infused Rose Sword. This one gives an extra 10% damage boost against humans, and all of the ninjas in the ninja arena are human race. So this will be very good. If you are a pay to win player and you have managed to gotten your hands on the rare Fallen Ice Dragon set weapons that came with a DC package, then show that instead, because that gives you an even bigger damage boost against human race characters. But for me, I don't have that, so I'm showing the Vow Infused Rose Sword instead. Okay, so let's go to Ninja Arena, and here you'll fight a bunch of monsters. You can fight anywhere between 1 to 3 different ninjas. Okay, what I want to do is Soul Gambit and then just Soul Rip. And ideally, everything should die. If it still doesn't die, then you want to use a little bit of Dragon Nova on your dragon. You get a 10% damage boost for using silver weapons, but the damage from Yuragiri outweighs that of the best silver weapon inside the game. So stick with Yuragiri. You can see here, one battle gives me 1.3k gold already. Very, very easy. On top of that 1.3k gold, you also get a ninja token. There are 4 different ninja tokens: the bronze ninja token, silver ninja token, gold ninja token, and platinum ninja token. Okay, the bronze one sells for 50 gold each, silver one sells for 75 gold each, the gold one sells for 100 gold each, and the platinum one sells for a whopping 5000 gold each. And this is why it is the best gold farming spot possible inside of the game. So I'll definitely recommend you to go ahead and do this quest. Okay, for this time, I only got 2 opponents, so we'll just do that. Sometimes you may not be able to kill him, but that's fine. Let's see here. Artix Pure should take care of him. Done. Then for Rawleaf, you can just do heavy. Oh, okay, he's still not dead. That's unfortunate. Okay, yeah, so sometimes you don't get so lucky if your crits, that's what happens, but it's still fine. 892 gold, still way better as compared to the Dr. Voltaboat's challenge. So this one, this gold farming spot, I only recommend if you are able to one shot or two shot the monsters. If not, you should go to Dr. Voltaboat instead, as that will be a slightly faster farming spot for you if you're not able to one shot the ninjas. Okay, now, other things I want to bring up. Okay, so first of all, the two spots that I've shown, Voltaboat for EXP and Ninja Arena for gold, these are very generic farming spots that you can use at almost any level. Okay, the Ninja Arena, I recommend it for higher level players who actually have good gear. The Voltaboat challenge, you can use it to grind both gold and EXP at any level, as long as you have a good energy weapon. So, I am aware that there are many other different good places and quests to farm for gold and EXP at the lower levels, but at the very top level, this is the two places that you really want to go. And the first place, the Dr. Voltaboat's challenge, it basically works for all levels. So if you're unsure of where to go, then just do Dr. Voltaboat. It's the fastest way possible. Okay, one other thing that I want to bring up is the X Boost, okay? Okay, so the X Boost you can get from inside your Book of Law, okay? And the X Boost, each X Boost gives you 10% more EXP and gold from battle. You can see there are 3 different X Boosts that you can buy. The 1-week X Boost, the 30-day X Boost, and the unlimited X Boost. Keep in mind, the 1-week and 30-day temporary X Boost, they do not stack at all. So you can only have one of each, and you only get a maximum of 10% increase to your EXP and gold. The unlimited ones, you can stack it up to 10, which if you have 10 of these, it'll essentially double the amount of EXP and gold you get. Okay, this one, it costs 1000 dragon coins, and I definitely would not recommend getting this X Boost unlimited, simply because eventually you're going to reach the max level, eventually you're going to have enough gold. Like, if you're farming as an average person per day, not much, say a few hours every day on top of doing the storyline, you can hit level 90 quite easily in about 2 months, 3 months. You know, it's not that difficult, maybe even lesser amount of time. Like, this is just playing the bare minimum every day and doing a little bit more to grind. Like, you're not even hardcore grinding 8 hours a day or something like that. You can hit level 90 in like 2 to 3 months. You know, it's not that difficult. If you are a heavy spender and do not have as much time to play, then you can consider buying the X Boosters. But for the regular player, I would say it's not worth it at all to buy the X Boost, simply because you will reach level 90 eventually just by doing the storyline, just by playing the game regularly every single day. As for gold, there isn't that many huge gold sinks inside of the game to warrant buying this just for the gold boost. There's only really 3 big gold sinks in the game in my opinion. The first of which is your Doom and Destiny weapons, which costs 28,000 gold each, maybe a little more if you're getting the upgrades as well. The second gold sink will be your Dragonlord artifacts here. They cost 325,000 gold each. I mean, you can get them for free using 750 dragon coins each, which is a total of 1,500 dragon coins, but why would you want to waste actual money on something that you can get for free just by farming? So for 750,000 gold total, you can get both of these Dragonlord artifacts. And the third item that you really need to spend money on, I would say, are the Soulforge rings and the Soulforge amulets. Those cost quite a little as well, but you know, overall I would say in your entire Dragon Fable career, you'll probably need slightly lesser than 1 million gold total, and that is honestly not a hard target to achieve if you are a regular player. Like, you really don't need the help from the X Boost in my opinion, and I think it's just a waste of money to buy the X Boost. Of course, if you have a lot of money but don't have a lot of time to play the game, you can buy the X Boost. I'm not saying you shouldn't buy it, but it's a want basically. It's not a need to buy it. So that will basically conclude my guide on farming inside of this game. I hope you guys have enjoyed. If you have learned something, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And if I left out any good farming spots or any other tips that you guys would like to share, please comment down in the comment section below. And that's it for this video, guys. Till the next time, I'm your host, Corban Gaming. Peace out.